This reading is for my beautiful, beautiful, extraordinary, beautiful Leos. Okay? I want to say thank you to all my subscribers, all my new subscribers. Welcome. If you haven't already, hit that bell button at the bottom so you can get a notification each time I upload. Okay, so we have kisses. Unconditional loving, giving and receiving, affection, and falling in love. So first card out is kisses. Someone loves you unconditionally, okay? Giving and receiving, affection. Somebody you want to give into this connection. You got somebody falling in love, sunseeds. Falling in love with you. Give me one more, Holy Spirit. Somebody wants to pour into this connection. Okay, wow, sunseeds. So we have passion, insane chemistry, like each other equally, having fun. Ooh, okay. So this is someone that you guys equally like each other. You guys, the passion, the chemistry, I heard the desire, is mutual between you and this person. You and this person enjoy your time together. And we have the chaser. Chaser and codependent relationship, fear of abandonment issues. Under the bottom, we have sunglasses, watching, looking, stalking. Somebody is stalking you, sunseeds. Twin flames, kings of ring. Ooh. The dragonfly, be lighthearted, finding out things coming to the light. I like you, not enough, heart with a key. All right, so for the ones who want a twin flame journey, okay, whoever the twin flame of yours is, they really, really into you, okay? And this person just feel like you're the one for them. They stalk you, they watch you. This could have been someone who had plenty of options. This could have been someone who was taking long to make a decision when it came to committing to this connection. This could be someone who, you know, with these many options, if they do have options, this is somebody that could be, you know, they have a lot of, you know, they could have, you know, one night stands with people. But this is somebody who doesn't give no one a real commitment, because the person who they want to give a commitment to is you. Okay. Somebody sees you as lighthearted. Somebody sees you as genuine passion. Somebody, I feel like with this energy, this person feels like if they're going to make a change, if they're going to truly settle down and commit to anyone, it will be you. Okay. This person just like everything about you. But I feel like it's something about this person where you don't feel like it's just enough. You know, you could have got frustrated with this relationship. This person definitely self-sabotaged this relationship. This person could have made you feel like a lack of confidence at times because they were so indecisive, you know. But the heart with the key, this is welcoming in love, meeting the one, open your heart, getting together. Perfect. Let's see. Somebody, it's giving me whoever the runner was. Now they want to chase you. Yeah. I got the deck upside down. Honeymoon and passion. Give me one, Holy Spirit. Somebody want a brand new start with you. This person could be watching and stalking you to see if you moved on to a new connection. Did you find love? I'm getting like, who you with? Who you talking to? Did you find new love? Did you move on? Twin flame. This person could be scared of you having other options besides them. Somebody knows that you're very attractive. You're very down to earth. Wow. I'm hearing if this person finds out that you dated anyone else, you're going to see another side of this person that you've never seen before. Sunseeds, I'm just a messenger. But some of you guys, you're probably like, mistake, sunflower, This could be someone who do a lot of things just for the moment and expect people to wait. on them. Yeah, pay attention to the red flags. Yeah, this person does a lot of stuff in a moment where, you know, this person just, this is somebody that's giving me, like, somebody who want to do what they want to do. And then when they're ready to commit to you, they're hoping that you be open and available. This is somebody who don't want you to move on. This is somebody selfish. This is somebody who so sabotaged your connection, okay, could have possibly just been out, you know, dating other people or having one-night stands. But, you know, trying to string you along as well. Like, how does that work? This person know they can't gaslight you. Yeah, playfulness. Pay attention to the red flag. This person be out playing. Pay attention to the red flag. This person be out playing, entertaining other options. But you got this person's heart. Okay? This person knows that you're the one for them. Somebody, this person just feels like you're perfect for them. This person could be also want to take you out on a date. Okay, this person wants to like flirt, get things back to where it used to be. Give me one more Holy Spirit. This could be also with this chaser. This is somebody who in and out of relationships because they have abandonment issue. This person could have been afraid that you was going to leave them or you was going to abandon them. For some of you guys, this person ghosted you and did it because this person ghosted you out of fear. This person could be intimidated about, intimidated. Yeah. This person could be intimidated by you. Like, somebody just feels like you're so beautiful, you're so down to earth, you're so lovable. Like, you're just the one. And somebody, instead of accepting that and receiving that, this person ran from it. Somebody felt like you was going to leave them. This person is used to dealing with people that's codependent on them, that need them. So it gives me an energy of like, you're very secure in yourself. You're not codependent. You know who you are. You love yourself. Empress or Emperor energy. And somebody, it makes somebody insecure. So somebody could have definitely possibly ghosted you because of some type of abandonment issues they have. This is somebody that's used to people that's very codependent and you weren't. Pay attention to the red flags of playfulness, Spirit is saying. Give me more, one more, Holy Spirit, one more. Yeah, express your love. Now this person wants to come in and express their love for you. Yes, under the bottom we have reconciliation. This person is coming back to express their love. This person can't avoid how insane the chemistry that you got is here. This person miss having fun with you. They miss hanging out with you. They miss dating you. They miss, I'm hearing they just miss your smell. They miss being around you. Like, somebody could have been around some funky ass energies. And all I can think about is Mystic Sunflower Collective Sun Seeds. Like, no, I just miss my person. And I'm not saying like somebody who like funky energies, like where they just stink. Like, I'm just saying like the energies is just not, it's not hitting like Mystic Sunflower Collective Sun Seeds. Yeah, with this heart with the key, like somebody know that you're the one. They know that. And now somebody wants to open their heart and give into this connection. They just feel like you're the perfect person for them. But this person, in the meantime, between time, this person is watching you, looking, stalking, trying to find out, have you moved on? Are you dating anyone else? This is definitely a twin flame. This person definitely could have many options, you know, left the options open, but it don't do it for this person because they're not you, Sunseeds. They like you. I like you. Someone likes you. Romance is blooming. Fun flirting and want to date. Somebody want to hang out with you. They miss that. Wow. So I heard that childlike energy. Somebody just miss you guys. No matter what age you guys are, somebody just miss like being like a big kid with you. Having fun. Hanging out. Doing the things that you guys do. Yeah. Reconciliation, keep an open mind. You deserve love. Let go. Control issues. Somebody was trying to control you, and they realize now that they can't just control you. You just naturally gonna be who you are. You are who you are. And somebody made you feel like you was undeserving of love. But you're more than deserving of love. Someone also thought that you were too perfect or you were too good to be, you know, just for them because of their past or because of the lifestyle that they live. But now someone is trying, you know, they're keeping an open mind. Somebody is realizing who you are to them. Somebody could be doing research, finding out about twin flames. But with this reconciliation, somebody is coming in because they want you to give this relationship a chance. But this was also somebody that gave you unrequited love at one time because they was unsure of this connection. Also, because this person is used to dating people that's codependent, that needs them, rely on them, and you was just like the totally opposite. But somebody is realizing that this could be the one, getting to know each other. Heart-to-heart conversation, honeymoon passion. Somebody could be wanting to go on a vacation with you or just go out on a date with you. Somebody want to get away and express their love with you. Somebody just wants some time with just you. Just you and them, you know? Block out the world. Block out everybody. Just you and them. Yeah, worth waiting for. Trust. Very soon. Ooh, divine timing is at work in your love life. Somebody coming back. I feel like whoever energy this is, this person, Divine is working on this person. Divine could be working on both of you guys. Somebody could have had codependency issues, whether that was people dependent on them, whether it was people, places, and things. It could have been a habit that someone had. But Divine is at work in you guys' love life at this time, okay? When this person comes around, they want you to trust them, okay? Religious factors, past life relationship. This is definitely someone you knew from your past, okay? You guys can have two different upbringings. If not, someone could just be more traditional. Maybe they was, you know, expecting to either marry or be in a relationship with somebody that, you know, was more traditional, did things a traditional way. And maybe you might be spiritual. Okay? That could be the two differences about you guys. The two things that make you guys opposite. But let your friends help you in codependency. Yeah, separation. Yes, like I said, it could be people, places, and things with this codependency. This could be somebody that always, you know, relied on their friends for advice or their family, you know, and they trusted whatever these people were, you know, were saying, you know. But you can't, I'm not saying it's not good to get advice from others when it comes to your relationship, you know, depending on how, you know, how much you trust that person. But if you're going to get advice from a friend or a family member or whoever about a twin flame connection, that's something that you got to consult with the divine about. Because if a person never been in a twin flame connection, and let's be honest, a lot of people don't even believe in twin flame connections, you know. Twin flame connections are very different, unique, and it's very few that understands, you know, the divine mission of a twin flame journey. So this person could have definitely, because, you know, consulting and with friends and family, and they could have, didn't give this person the best advice, and this person could have made a decision that they're now in regret about, and now they want to reconcile with you. I picked up earlier, this person could be researching twin flames. Yeah. So, let's see some seeds. Let's pull for the tarot. Yeah, Ace of Pentacles and eight. Crack the deck. Come through, Holy Spirit. Come through, Holy Spirit. Crack the deck on Ace of Pentacles and Ace of Swords. A brand new beginning. My nose over here just chuckling and it's itching. Spirit is saying that is the truth. That is the truth. Okay, somebody is now seeing the truth. The Moon card to the Chariot. It's like somebody is seeing the truth about some type of, you know, illusion or something that was hidden. Somebody is seeing something. Yeah, the Wheel of Fortune, and it's changing everything. the chariot to the moon, I feel like as well, this person could just be moving it in secret. Like, this person could be not be telling people what's going on. This person is giving me, like, moving in silence, you know, because they know the truth. Somebody could have definitely been researching twin flame connections. The chariot to the moon to the ace of swords. It's like this person is moving in silence because maybe they feel like this person, people, they friends or they family member, maybe they don't accept, you know, you, or maybe they don't approve of this connection. But now that somebody knows the truth with this big ace here, it changes everything. And now this person wants to come in and bring you an offer. Ace of Pentacles to the Judgment. Wow. Yeah, somebody knows who they want to be with. But maybe there's energies that don't, you know, like I said, you know, don't approve of this connection. I'm hearing if you guys team up, if you guys be together, a lot of people be scared of both of you guys. I guess your person is just as powerful as you, and people are intimidated by that. Yeah. I feel like if you guys get together, a lot of people will be scared of both of you guys. This person could just be just as powerful as you are, Sunseed. Wow, confirmation. I heard powerful in the spirit in my head. Okay. Yeah, so it was these karmic jobs to try to keep you guys away from each other. Give me more of this energy, Holy Spirit. Please and thank you. Yes, Queen of Cups. Queen of Cups to the Eight of Swords. I feel like with the Queen of Cups to the Eight of Swords, the Seven of Cups, yeah. Somebody definitely kept their options open because this person knew how loving, how caring, you know, how nurturing and just giving me an energy of how much you love them. And they wanted to, like, keep you stuck, trapped down, and bonded, you know, or because somebody didn't want nobody else to get your love. And I picked up on that earlier, like, somebody felt like they could just, like, do what they want, and then, you know, you would be stuck, and, you know, I'm a clarifier, but I'm just channeling right now. It just gave me an energy where somebody felt like you was going to be, you know, when they done having fun, they was going to be able to come back to you. Somebody with this Queen of Cups in the Swords, somebody wanted you to be bonded to them. Give me a card on the Eight of Swords. Or somebody wanted you to be in your head about this. Eight of Swords is clarified with the Ace of Cups. Yeah, like somebody thought that, okay, because you love them, you know, they just figured that you will be in your head. Eight of Swords, Ace of Cups, it's like you'll be in your head about this love. Oh, like somebody knew for a fact, like, nah, I know that person, they're a good girl, they're a good guy. I know they ain't gonna move on. Mm-mm. I know what I did was a number on them. Like, I know they're not gonna move on. I know they're gonna be in their feelings when it comes to this connection. Like, what? Page of Swords, but they watching you. This person is stuck on you. Thank you, Spirit. This person is stuck on this Queen of Cups, man or female, you know. This man is, okay, well, Spirit said this man. Somebody is stuck on this Queen of Cups. They in love. They all in their feelings about this Queen of Cups. They know who they want. They said, I like you. Okay? Someone likes you. Romance is blooming. And they watch and they stalk you. Yeah. Sunseeds, what y'all do to this person? But that's, you know, the shit twin flame. Something changed where this person is all in their feelings when it comes to you. Mm-hmm. Somebody in love. I feel like on an energy, for an energy where it was once one-sided, now the same way how you felt about this person, or how you still feel about this person now feels the same way. It's like this person, could be talking to their friends and expressing how much they love you, and their friends like, listen, like, you know, cool it down, like, you know, just chill out, like, chill out. You acting like you really you know what I'm saying? Like, whoever they friends is, they not used to this person acting out like this. They like, chill out. Like, but the Ace of Cups, somebody is all in their feelings, Knight of Cups. Yeah, somebody not the same no more. Somebody feel like, listen, something about this person has changed since the separation. And they feel like they won't be the same until they get back with to their love. This how this person feel. Give me a card on the Ace of Cups, Holy Spirit. They feel like you guys could be seeing eagles. Somebody feels like they won't be the same until they get back to the person who they truly love. Ace of Cups. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Somebody fell in love. Mm-hmm. They were trying to avoid it. Wheel of Fortune. Wheel of Fortune Empress. They was trying to avoid it. Yeah, the Devil to the Justice. You get karmic justice. Could be dealing with a Capricorn, a Libra, a Taurus, or a Pisces, or a Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio. Somebody's obsessing over you. Somebody's obsessing with coming in, balancing things out, making things fair. They like, somebody like, they friends like, chill. Somebody is just like, no, I want my person. Six of Pentacles. I want to give to this connection. Give me a call on the Ace of Cups. Yeah, Ten of Swords. What's the Ten of Swords? It's like if somebody betrayed you, Sunseed, somebody realized that they only betrayed themselves by going up again. It's like, because you know with twin flames, you guys share the same soul. So if this person hurts you, they only wind up hurting themselves. You understand? What's the Ten of Swords, Holy Spirit? Ten of Swords clarify with the Ace of Pentacles. You got two aces out here. Somebody want a brand new beginning with the person that they truly in love with. And with the Eight of Swords being here in the middle of the Queen of Cups to the Ace of Cups, somebody can't get out their head about this Two of Cups, this person who they want to be with. Mm-mm. They can't. This person could have tried to control things in the past, but they see that they didn't get them anywhere. Somebody is stuck in their head about the person who they love. That's all they think about. All they think about is this, you know, having this beautiful new opportunity with this person who they see as a twin flame. The chaser. Somebody coming in chasing your behind. I'm telling you, can't go on to the Knight of Swords, Hangman. I'm telling you, somebody seeing things different. Somebody about to come in and take action on you. Yeah, somebody realized with this Ten of Swords, if they hurt you, they hurt themselves, you know? Because you guys, like I said, you guys could have ascended Sunseeds or went through some type of ascension, you or your person, but I feel like you guys are mirroring each other. Like, you guys are mirroring the same energy. Give me more on the Queen of Cups, Holy Spirit, Queen of Cups. Queen of Cups is clarified with the Five of Pentacles to the Knight of Cups. Yeah, somebody realizing that they left the person that they love out in the cold. That was their wish fulfillment. This could have been somebody who was gaslighting you. You know, was focused on other things. Yeah, because it says, I like you. Yeah, the kingdom. This person knows that they're in love with you. Somebody sees you as they yin to their yang, but I feel like with that Queen of Cups, you was real lighthearted to this person. But this person did something. But that Justice to the Devil, it was something about this person was afraid. Or they had ego issues because they felt like because they couldn't control you, they felt like you could have not been the one. This person will get real jealous if they find out that you know, dating other people or you with someone else. Mm-hmm. Give me a card on the Five of Pentacles, Holy Spirit. This person sees you as a Ten of Cups, they need emotional fulfillment. But somebody feels out in the cold now. But I feel like this is how they left you. They left you out in the cold. They left you out in the cold. Now this person wants to come back chasing. What's the Five of Pentacles, Holy Spirit? But it was all out of fear. It was out of fear. Somebody knew how they felt about you. Yeah, Five of Cups. Now they're in regret. This person could be going through changes. 5-5. Here, 5 of Cups to the 5 of Pentacles. This person could be going through a lot of changes. And it could be difficult because I feel like you guys, somebody is going through ascension. You know? You guys could definitely be mirroring the same energy. This person could be just, you know, deciding to just, you know, how can I say it? You know, move in silence. I also feel like, Sussy, this person hid their emotions for you. They hid their emotions how they truly felt. Something about this person's energy was, like, real stinky. So maybe this person was, like, surrounded by people that, you know, it could have been a lot of negative energy around this person. It's like somebody had to get by themselves, clear their energy, cleanse their energy for something to come in. Somebody seeing things different. Yeah, Ace of Wands, that's the truth. Give me a card on the Nine of Cups. Nine of Cups, Holy Spirit. Thank you. The Nine of Cups is clarified with the Five of Swords. They could be feeling defeated because of the situation that they self-sabotage. Three of Pentacles. This person could have been trying to prove a point to a bunch of nobodies. That's what I'm getting. A bunch of nobodies. Okay? People that were just jealous of you guys. Because I heard if you guys get together, like, a lot of people will be scared of y'all. I don't know how, why that came out, but take it how it resonates. So, I picked up intuitively, like, you guys, you know, both of you guys could be very powerful. Of course you guys are. You guys, twin flames, you know, twin flame connection get together. It ain't nothing. A twin flame connection, they get together in a healthy union, they could take over the world. Period. Confirmation, you got a lot of that plain name. Like, they could, you guys work together. Yeah, Five of Swords to the Three of Pentacles. People know you guys work together and team up that you guys, like, a force to be reckoned with, like, and it will make a lot of people jealous. You got 3 fives here, 5, 5, 5. So something is changing. That's why we seen earlier, divine timing is at play in your love life. You got an Ace of Cups, Ace of Pentacles. Y'all about to get a brand new beginning when it comes to a twin flame connection. And when you guys team up and work together, a lot of people gonna feel defeated. They gonna feel left out in the cold because you guys are not gonna be, you know, people are not going to have your attention the way how they used to have, you know, be able to have your attention or be able to, you know, have your energy, you guys being around. You guys, you and this person are going to be all about each other. All of that other stuff is over with. It's just going to be about you and this person. And if you guys got children, about your children. But everybody else is going to be irrelevant. And they know that. They know if y'all work together, y'all going to be a problem. You had a world card to the Five of Wands. You got 4 fives out here. So they were trying to cause challenges and obstacles so a cycle wouldn't close out with them. You got a bunch of people. This could be a family, friends, people in this person in the circle. 6 of Wands, that's a yes. The 3 of Swords. Yeah, these people are going to be hurt. 6 of Swords, yeah, because you guys are being guided to move away to calmer waters. You guys could be deciding to relocate. Knight of Pentacles, 7 of Wands. Yeah, somebody was trying to either delay or block someone. That's why things was moving slow when it comes to your Ten of Cups and Ace of Swords. Spiritually, that's the damn truth. Somebody is seeing the truth that people don't want to see them happy. And the people that don't want to see them happy is the people that's around them. I'm talking about the people that's close to you, right? That's how it be. Spiritually, again, Ace of Swords. That's the damn truth. We see the Ace of Yami times. Spirit just clarifying. Spirit said that's the damn truth. It'd be the people that be the closest to you. Okay? And that's how we go. They be using Zen will use anybody, you know? They karmics. They use anybody because they only want these twin flames to come together. 2 of Cups with the 3 of Cups. Celebrating, being happy. 2 people got eyes for each other, but with the Judgment keeps sticking out. That ain't gonna happen anyway. It was Judgment to the Emperor. You see, earlier we seen Judgment to the Empress. Damn! Earlier we seen Judgment to the Empress. Now Spirit got Judgment to the Emperor. Yeah, so both of you guys are, you guys know who y'all want. Y'all know who y'all want. Y'all know who y'all want to be with. And that's just final. Period. That's why it says right here, insane chemistry, like each other equally, having fun. Both of you guys love and like each other equally. And one, something is going to happen quick. Four wands when it comes to, yeah, something's going to happen quick. This shit's twin flame. When it comes to this relationship, a marriage, a proposal, a celebration, a house, a move-in, like, something is happening quick. King of Swords to the Justice, like, period. It's giving me an energy of somebody growing up and they seeing the truth. Somebody's maturing. Somebody knows who their person is and they want to come and balance things out. Yeah, I even see the Sun card behind it. Mm-hmm. Something is being exposed where now somebody sees the truth. Three of Cups. If there was a third party that was trying to keep you guys away from each other, somebody could definitely be going through legal issues or be, in a court in a 3D. But for others of you guys, somebody could be in spiritual jail for trying to come between this, twin flame. It was definitely a third party. Three of Cups to the Magician to the Ace of Wands. This is something that you manifested, but somebody was trying to block somebody manifest. Yeah, the Moon card, Queen of Pentacles. Yeah, it was a karmic. Somebody had to cut out a karmic. Mm-hmm. The Chariot to the Queen of Pentacles. Somebody could be leaving an earth sign behind. Ace of Swords again. Spiritually, that's the damn truth. Somebody had to cut out a karmic. So somebody could be realizing who a karmic is in their life. And they had to let go of that energy. So that could have been a reason why you guys were delayed and hold up. Because somebody had to release a karmic. Somebody who was not who they were supposed to be with. Okay? You could have found out that this person was in a commitment with somebody else, gave somebody else a commitment, or entertaining someone else. Take it how it resonates. Yeah. But if they were, this person could never get you with the Queen of Cups to the Eight of Swords and Ace of Cups. This person could, they never ever got you out their head. Like, if they was like physically somewhere else, their mind was always with you. Mm-mm. What's the Eight of Swords, Holy Spirit? The Eight of Swords. Ace of Wands. Somebody wants this brand new beginning. That's what they're in their head about. They want this brand new passionate beginning with you. You got three aces. Is somebody going for this? Somebody is very sure about this Three of Cups, this Ace of Wands, Ace of Cups, Ace of Pentacles. They are sure about this reconciliation. But somebody is going to get hurt. In the process, whoever this karmic is, they wasn't supposed to be with this damn karmic anyway. And this person could have experienced some type of karma or some type of changes in their life for dealing with this karmic that they had no business being with because they betrayed you. Yeah, Four of Swords. I said they had no business being with this person anyway. Something is coming to rest. Six of Swords. Yeah, it's coming to rest. Somebody is feeling guided to come towards you to make things right. They're being guided to put something to rest. Four of Swords to the Six of Swords. That's this Ten of Swords right here. Whoever this karmic is, they know that. And they feel betrayed by your person or they feel hurt. So they were trying to like make things challenging or make things hard for this person to move on. Wow. Yeah, Five of Wands, Seven of Cups, the Devil. Ooh. This person was trying to cause a lot of problems in this person's life, so they wouldn't move on. Two of Pentacles. Four of Pentacles, because they wanted to hold on to this person. Ooh. Wow. Yeah, so whoever this karmic is, they is hurt. Because they thought this person was the one for them. They thought they was going to be with this person, marry this person. But this person is some type of truth that this person realized and they out of there. Somebody is like, what's the sense of being with someone physically if I'm in love with someone else? But somebody could know that this person is toxic, so they had to move a certain way. Maybe this person was protecting you. What's the Six of Swords, Holy Spirit? Well, the Six of Swords is here, the Death card. This person is experiencing a transformation. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Because they being guided to go a whole nother direction. Somebody could definitely be going through ascension. Queen of Pentacles, Knight of Pentacles, whoever this damn earth sign is, we're trying to slow this person up from coming in their Two of Cups with the Empress. I can't make it up. They were trying. Yeah, because whoever this karmic is, they feel like this person, like, just changed up on them. Like, the death card, they feel like this person just changed up on them. Like, where is this coming from? But somebody realized some type of truth about this connection. And they were trying to slow this person up, the Hangman. They see something different now with the Queen of Swords. They see something about, Page of Cups. They see something about the energy that they was dealing with. Yeah, and it changed everything. Wheel of Fortune to the Queen. Wheel of Fortune to the Higher Friend. Maybe they gave this person a commitment. Maybe somebody was married to someone. But with the Chariot, somebody getting the hell up out of there. The Chariot to the Six of Cups. Yeah, the Eight of Wands. Somebody is leaving. Yeah, somebody is going. Yeah, they leaving because they want to reconcile with their twin. And somebody was trying to make it hard for them. Only major arcana we have out here is, okay, the Death and the Higher Friend. This is God. This is the Most High. This is divine. Divine is forcing this change, this transformation, the Death to the Higher Friend. This is the Most High forcing this change. We have the Ace of Cups. Look. Only major arcana we have here is the Ace of Wands, the Ace of Cups, the Ace of Pentacles, the Death card, and the Higher Friend. God is forcing this change, okay? This is... God is forcing this whole change. Somebody is more than deserving of this new beginning. Yeah, somebody going through a transformation of the World card. Five of Wands. Things are ending. Challenges, obstacles, people cause a problem. That is all over with. What's the Death card? This person could have been, you know, lost in the stores before, but somebody now sees the truth about things. The Death card. Somebody seeing the truth about things now. Yeah, Four of Wands. Somebody is preparing for a twin flame union. Yeah, Ten of Pentacles. The Hermit. Somebody, guys, is here working on this together. Yeah, both of y'all spirit guides and your ancestors could be working to bring you guys together in this Ten of Pentacles. Yeah, somebody feel like they never experienced the love like this before. Somebody knows where their heart is at. The Death card is clarified with the Four of Wands. There's a transformation that's happening for somebody, you know, two people to go into union. What's the Higher Friend? And if somebody was married to a karmic or in a commitment with a karmic, that would be handled business being, that is over with. And somebody not taking it well. What's the Higher Friend? You don't thank your Holy Spirit. The Higher Friend is clarified with the Seven of Wands. Yeah, this union is protected. Here's another part of the Seven of Wands. Something is very much protected. Five of Wands, the Knight of Cups. It's protected. I also feel like you protected as well. If this person has like options or karmics or toxic or karmic family members, karmic friends, I feel like you are being protected. You're being protected from that as well. Wheel of Fortune to the Six of Cups. Somebody know that you're going to have a lot of options as well. Somebody feels like they know that it's competition. They're very aware. Somebody very aware that it's competition. The Seven of Wands to the High Friend. The King of Pentacles. Yeah, I feel like for a lot of you guys, the reason why y'all didn't come into union with this person, you know, when you guys probably was expecting before, it was because this person could have definitely been in a commitment with someone else, and spirit was protecting you from that energy. Seven of Swords to the Tower. Yeah, because somebody was lying, or, you know, lying to you, or deceiving you in some type of way. But they're going to go through a tower, you know, because they can't, like, this spirit is like, if you're not going to come correct, they cannot come next to you, the Empress or the Emperor at all. They cannot. They just can't. Page of Cups. Somebody could be wanting to come and apologize to you about lying in the past. Because I just see the Six of Cups a couple of times. Lying to you about in the past. What's the human card in the King of Pentacles? King of Pentacles, Holy Spirit. Thank you. King of Pentacles, clarify with the Chariot. Somebody is moving on. Four Cups. What's the Chariot? A lot of you guys could have decided to move on some season. Focus on your finances. Focus on yourself. What's the King of Pentacles, the Chariot? A lot of you guys could have been very much aware of what this person had going on. You decided to focus on, you know, your abundance. Ace of Swords again. Spiritually, that's the damn truth. I'm going to leave it here. Okay, so I see. I'm going to leave it here. Knight of Swords to the Judgment. To the Empress. Somebody mad as heck, Empress. Somebody is so mad. Okay? Somebody is mad. Somebody mad that you see the truth. Okay? Somebody is angry. Nine of Wands, Queen of Wands, Ten of Cups, Six of Pentacles. Oof. Knight of Wands. To the World card. Seven of Swords, the Tower. Somebody is just angry as hell because they feel like, listen, Empress, like you went from the Queen of Wands to the Empress, you know, all queens in the deck, Seven of Cups, like you got mad options. You know, this person feels like it's going to be work to come back and get this person back. They also know the Queen of Cups that you're very intuitive. You got great discernment. Okay. Somebody know they can't play no mind games with you. Because you're going to see right through the truth each and every single time. That could have been a reason why you moved on at the first time and called judgment on this person's head. Three of Swords. Now somebody hurt before a Pentacle because they want to hold on to you. Yeah. Somebody could have watched you boss up. Page of Cups. They want to come and apologize. Two of Cups. The Emperor, yeah, this your Emperor want to come in and apologize. Three of Wands for having you wait. Two of Wands, okay, for their choices and decisions that they made in the past. Two of Swords to the Ten of Pentacles. This person feel blocked from your energy, the Tower. Or they felt blocked from your energy. What's the Three of Wands, Holy Spirit? I feel like this person had you waiting. And you was like, what? I'm going to focus on me. Six of Wands to the Nine of Swords. Somebody thought you was going to be in your head waiting on them. And that's what I'm saying earlier. Somebody thought because you loved them so much that you was going to wait on them. Huh? And now they're stressed out about it. What's the Nine of Swords? Confirmation. What's the Nine of Swords? Nine of Swords, clarify with the Ten of Wands, King of Cups. Whoever this King of Cups is that want to come in and communicate with you and make things right, they know that it's going to, you know, it's not going to be easy. It's not going to be easy because of what they have done to you. Yeah, Page of Pentacles, Knight of Pentacles. This person is working on something. They could be working on their finances. This person could be working on, their job. Something is being delayed, okay? Give me a card on the Nine of Pentacles. Okay, so that could have been a major delay as well with this person because this person was trying to work on their finances before they come towards you. What's the Knight of Pentacles? This person could be trying to work on their finances before they come towards you as well. I just say the Wheel of Fortune to the Temperance. What's the Knight of Pentacles, Holy Spirit? This person felt like they had to have their finances correct. Yeah, the High Priestess. Yeah, Ten of Pentacles. Yeah, so this person is secretly working on their finances, like I said, before they come towards you. And they could be feeling like they had some type of delay. Yeah, Three of Swords, and that could be the reason why they hurt. Five of Pentacles, because they feel out in the cold, the Hermit. This person is being, you know, I feel like their spirit guides is working with them, though. Seven of Swords, the Devil, but they want to come up in reverse. So somebody no longer want to be toxic, they no longer want a lie, scheme. The Hangman is giving me like now somebody is ready to surrender to their Queen of Cups, Page of Swords, and that's why they watching you, stalking you. Give me a card of the Devil in reverse. Yeah, somebody no longer want to be toxic. They no longer want to lie and be deceitful. Spiritually, that's the guess. Ace of Swords, the Wheel of Fortune to the Ace of Pentacles. Yeah, somebody don't longer want to be a liar anymore. They want to do things right. They in love, Sunsteeds. So you gotta We got seen to that. With the three of wands and the two of wands, I feel like you got a decision, a choice to make some things. If this is what you want, because this is what's coming in for you. Okay? So, I hope this video was able to help you guys, give you guys clarity on your situation. It's going to be different for what you guys think would resonate and leave the rest behind. Let me get you one or two more cards from this deck before I close it. Yeah, somebody that was once trying to control the situation, they feel like they lost control. Yeah, they should have never, you shouldn't be trying to control anybody more. You should be trying to control anyone. I feel like now somebody is just like, Spirit is saying go with the flow, you know? Yeah, go with the flow. Not today, not dealing with hurt, avoided a conversation. This person is still angry. Somebody is angry, separation. And what's this cassette? Outdated thinking, conditioning, replaying events over in the air. Yeah. This is somebody who's going through a transformation because there's some type of outdated thinking that they thought like it was supposed to be one way and this how it's supposed to be with my person. No, Spirit is like, no, you said you wanted this person. I didn't bring it in the way you said it. You know, I mean, I didn't bring it in the way you asked for it. You know, this person had to be open to something and be open-minded that your person is not going to be the way how you expect them to be. Something about this person thinking was outdated, okay? So, yeah, this person was avoiding you because they didn't want to have this conversation, but now somebody wants to come and apologize. I also feel like whoever your person is, they saying not today to whoever that karmic. Somebody is avoiding that karmic. They don't want to argue. They setting up boundaries. They avoiding whoever that person is. They don't want to talk to that person because they feel like that person is toxic. Yeah, separation. Somebody is done with it, okay? They don't want no parts of it. Yeah, wedding rings. Mm-hmm. Wedding rings and abundance, Spirit is saying. You about to get married to your twin flame. Yeah. And somebody else, yeah. Somebody is, like, addicted. Well, this could have been before, in the past. Somebody had some type of addictions that could have been, that addiction could have been a codependency. You know, somebody had to go through a transformation and release that. And I said it earlier, somebody definitely ascended. Mm-hmm. Somebody went through ascension. So, Celsius, I hope this video was able to help you guys, give you guys clarity on your situation. Until we get up next time. Yeah, the chaser is now. I'm sorry, the runner is now the chaser. Yeah, whoever ran before, they coming in now. Mm-hmm. Yeah, because they healthy choices in mirror. So, thank you, Spirit. So, I feel like both of you guys are mirroring each other with the ascension. So, if you making healthy choices, you know you mirroring that back to your twin flame. And now they're able to do the same. Yeah. And now they want to call you. Mm-hmm. Yeah, somebody is not beat to argue with that karmic. They is over with. Somebody could have found out the karmic stabbed them in the back. They just don't want to deal with it. Or the karmic, thank you, Spirit. The karmic feels stabbed in the back, Spirit is saying. Yeah, the sword of rose. That's clarity. That's the truth. Whoever the karmic is, they feel stabbed in the back by your person because your person is leaving. I mean, hey, they ain't no business over there and he got to go away.